how do we prevent our teams from sending the wrong information to the wrong people? While most organizations will take measures to prevent and protect against external cyber attacks, many don't protect themselves against accidental leaks by their internal staff. Accidental disclosure is the unintentional release or sharing of sensitive information, and it's a huge cause of data breaches, especially in Australia. In the last quarter of 2019, human error was the cause of 32% of reported data breaches. Sending private information to the wrong person can be pretty damaging, right? It can be embarrassing for your company, it can have a potentially dramatic effect on the disclosed party, and under Australia's privacy laws, businesses need to have security measures in place to protect personal data from being leaked unintentionally. So how does an accidental data breach occur? It's often a staff member sending an email to the wrong person or inadvertently attaching a document that contains sensitive information. It could also be sending personally identifiable information such as tax file numbers, credit card information, passport information over insecure channels. So what steps can we take to prevent accidental data leakage in our company? Well, it might be obvious, but it starts with user education and training. There's plenty of resources out there for this. This video is mostly going to focus on the tools that we can put in place to create a safety net should users make mistakes. Now, the first tool that we're going to look at is called Communication Compliance. It's the latest addition to Microsoft's Insider Risk toolset, and it helps you detect, capture, and take remediation actions when your team sends inappropriate messages. So what's an inappropriate message? It could be something that goes against your HR policies, like the sending of harassment, inappropriate or offensive language. It can also detect adult, racy, or gory images. You could use pre-configured templates to identify sensitive information types. So this could be credit card information, passport numbers, medical information. And you can also create a custom policy that detects references to confidential and internal projects based on certain keywords that you were set up in the custom policy. And once an inappropriate message is detected, Communication Compliance triggers an alert for investigation and remediation. Now, the next tool is data loss prevention policies. While Communication Compliance monitors your organization for inappropriate messages, data loss prevention can actually stop them from being sent in the first place. These policies allow you to block or impose conditions on the sharing of sensitive information. So with DLP, data loss prevention, you can specify the types of content that can't leave your organization. These sensitive info types include credit card information, tax file numbers, driver's license information, and there's heaps of others. Our team can also use Office 365 message encryption, and this can encrypt email and attachments to ensure that only the intended recipients can view their contents. You can also prevent recipients from forwarding, saving, copying, or printing your emails and attachments. Encryption can be applied by default to all messages. It can be enabled manually by users, and it can also be applied automatically using those DLP policies based on the type of information that you're sharing. Sensitivity labels are part of information protection in Microsoft 365. You can label your files and emails according to their sensitivity level, and then policies can be applied relating to these levels. By appropriately labeling emails and files, you can ensure that your most sensitive information is accessible by trusted recipients no matter where it ends up, because the label is attached to the item, it is carried with it wherever it goes. So even if your file or email ends up on some other system, the protection is actually baked in. And you actually don't have to rely on users labeling files according to their arbitrary choice. You can use an automated scanner to scan the contents of files, and depending on keywords that are in it or sensitive information types that file contains, a label is applied automatically and the protection is applied automatically to those files. You can also configure built-in alerts in Microsoft 365 for external sharing. There's alerts in Microsoft 365 that can notify you each time a file is shared externally or when an unusual volume of file sharing occurs. You can also purchase and configure Microsoft Cloud App Security. It's included in some of the higher level plans like Microsoft 365 E5, but it can also be added on to any other Microsoft 365 plan. It can detect suspicious activities across not just Microsoft 365, but a bunch of other third-party cloud apps. For example, it can let you know if someone performs a mass delete or download or external share of your information from SharePoint, OneDrive, Dropbox, Business, Google Drive, Box, whatever you use. It can also provide detailed external reports and insights into how your information is shared externally. Your team should be sharing files via cloud storage rather than file attachments. When you share files via cloud storage, you can set access control and permissions on the links. You can set timed expiries. You can view audit logs of file access to understand who's viewing the data. And if you do need to use a file attachment to send an email, then you should be using Office 365 message encryption to encrypt that, or information protection to label that content to ensure that the protection is carried along with that file that you're sharing. Now, of course, there are significant considerations and configurations required to get some of these policies set up. At GCITS, we've got experience putting these things in for some organizations with complex security requirements, but we've also got some pretty typical profiles that we think suit most Australian businesses. So if you need help putting these policies in with minimal disruption to your team, and you want to make sure that your team can work with unimpeded access to their files, knowing that these automated safety nets are in place, then we'd be happy to help with that. You can get in touch with us at gcits.com.